My name is Meenakshi. I wrote all these books, but I also read a lot, as you can see from my library. I have this ginormous collection of books that I've yet to read, which are like bigger than, I think, my height right now. Last year, I read about 175 books. That's new books, not counting rereads, because I do a lot of rereads as well. And this year, my goal is to read 170 books. I mean, we all know how to read. We know the basics. Maybe you were a child who read a lot. I was. And maybe you weren't. Maybe you're an adult who thinks, oh, how should I start my reading habit up? And this is going to sound really basic, but the best way to start a reading habit is to start. And now don't get yourself one of those books that you think that you should read. You know, the ones that you've been putting off reading forever, your Tolstoy, your massive non-fiction, The Fate of Humankind or whatever. Get yourself a book that looks like you want to be drawn into the story. Get yourself a book that when you look at the back cover, you're like, oh, I would rather read this than watch that show on Netflix tonight. And that is how you begin. Then you want to start diversifying yourself a little bit. So for example, you like detective fiction, you've been reading murder mysteries, you've been reading one after the other. By this point, you can almost tell who did it by page 50 or something. Then start looking around, start Googling what are the best murder mysteries in the world. You notice that books have a kind of domino effect. So one book will start influencing you to read another book. For example, you start reading a book about a fictional author's life. I don't know, say Possession by A.S. Byatt. And once you read that, you're like, I'm really interested in what was going on in the background of this book. I am going to start looking at books which deal with the same background. I'm going to start looking at 18th century literature. I want to know more about these people in this life. And you'll notice that each book that sparks off something in you will lead to a little cluster of other books around it, like a pod almost, where you're reading one and it sort of flowers out to reveal a whole lot of other books that you can read within the area. I think I trained myself to read fast when I was a kid. I just like read from page to page. A lot of people say, isn't it skimming? But no, I think I retain quite a lot from what I'm reading, if not all of it. I get a sense of the atmosphere the writer's trying to convey, but I'm also skipping ahead to the action which I want to look at. So I'm not getting mired down by detail. So I encourage you to skip the bits that are boring. Just look through them for dialogue, look through them for any key points that might come up later, and just like skim way past it. Skim, 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 skim. And that brings me to abandoning books. If you don't like something you're reading, even after page 50, ditch it. There is no shame in ditching a book. Just like get rid of it. Be like, I don't want to read this anymore. It is not for me. Good way to clock all these books on Goodreads is also a way to see what kind of genres you're reading that year. Some years I'm very into historical fiction. Some years I'm very into fantasy. Last year was a year of crime because I was researching a crime novel which I'm writing right now. Read all the time. I mean, that is the only way I get all my stuff done. I read constantly. Every time I have a break, I read. I mean, I do watch a lot of television and I do go out as well. And I have stuff to do, you know. And yet, in the cracks of my time, I read. When I'm on a flight, I read. When I'm traveling, I read. When I'm waiting for a friend at a restaurant, I usually have a book in my bag so I can read waiting for them. Before I go to sleep, I read. So the only way to build a reading habit is reading. To summarize, if I can remember all the many tips I have given you, don't be afraid to ditch. Skim the parts that don't seem that relevant to you. Read around whatever genre interests you. Begin easy and then slowly start expanding your repertoire. And I would really encourage making a Goodreads list for yourself.